Hi everyone, it's Melanie and welcome back to Living Luxuriously for Less. So I wanted to go ahead and share our most recent wedding with you guys. This is the one that you've all been waiting for, but of course I always like to start with a before of the space. Now this particular wedding is the wedding that I also paired with my Lux Academy class. So a lot of the work that you will be seeing in this video was done by the students of Lux Academy. So here is the after. It turned out so amazing. The bride's theme was more like an African royalty. She loved the movie Coming to America. And so we wanted to use a lot of the violets and pinks and purples and all those colors. And of course, lots of gold. We accented the tables with the reversible trumpet vases that you see. And you guys remember seeing those as well in a sample setup video that we did. I will link that video down below. And also these amazing napkin rings, you guys. I love the fact that the napkin rings matches the gold beads around the charger plates. Absolutely stunning. And the candlelight adds such an ambiance to the table. So I like to add as much candlelight as possible to every table. Although this was filmed in the daytime, it did get darker as the night progressed, but I just wanted you guys to see exactly what it looked like with the candles lit. The flowers were absolutely stunning. And one of the things that I will tell you, although I can design flowers, a lot of times it makes more sense to use a florist in terms of timing. One of the activities that we did in Lux Academy, one of the labs that we did, was taking the students through putting together an entire tablescape and timing themselves so that they could see how long it would take them to pull together an entire room. So my local florist Kaleidoscope did an amazing job on the flowers. I picked out the colors and they just arranged them beautifully. So they were just absolutely stunning. I love some hanging on the taller centerpieces. I do like for them to hang a little bit. And my bride, she just really liked different shapes. So we didn't go with the round ball that you see all the time for the taller centerpieces. We opted to go with a more organic feel. So that turned out absolutely stunning.
How long has it been since I kissed you?
I love introducing something new at every wedding, and at this particular wedding, we had a lot of something news. One of them being these gorgeous and opulent chairs that we used at the head tables. They were such a huge hit, and they made a major, major statement in the room. Another one of them was these amazing table numbers. And so I would love to announce today that we have teamed up with Totally Dazzled to create a Luxe Bling Box collection. And in this collection, it houses all of my favorite pieces from Totally Dazzled. Now, this particular table number holder made such the perfect statement. One of the things that we wanted to do was, instead of using table numbers, we decided to use some of the couple favorite songs. And when it was that particular guest table time to eat, the DJ would play their song and they would dance to the line, to the buffet. And they really enjoyed it. It went over really, really well. And I love the fact that the table numbers did not take away from the decor like the big silver ones that you see in most banquet halls, but they rather added to the decor and they played very, very well with these beautiful napkin rings. And I love giving my bride that personal experience where she got to personally shop for her napkin rings and her napkin holder using the Luxe Bling Box collection. And so I will be sure to leave that link down below. Right now, we are also doing a $100 gift card. So if you would like to enter, head on over. I will leave the link down below and you guys can thank me later. Now let's talk about this amazing sweetheart table setup. Oh my goodness. You guys have seen me use these Mr. and Mrs. letters before. I got those from Hobby Lobby and I simply glittered them. If you would like a really quick tutorial on that, leave me a comment down below. But I just thought it looked so amazing with the candles and the beautiful floral runner that just went down the center of the table along with the king and queen chairs. Now this was a great accent because the last name of this couple was actually King. And so her hashtag was turning a queen into a king. And I just thought that was so much fun. The uplighting was done in the same violet purplish color. It was totally amazing. And then for the napkins on their tables, on the sweetheart table, we actually mixed the two colors. So we mixed the purple and we mixed more of the wine color. And it just really looked so good together. I just thought it was absolutely amazing. And I think the color for this is actually magenta. But if you Google magenta, it does come like in hot pink and all different shades. But this one was more of a purplish tone with a hint of pink, and then we used the pink in the floral, so it just turned out stunning. You can find the glassware seen here at Z Gallery all year round, or during the Christmas and Thanksgiving holidays, you can find it at Ross or TJ Maxx for a much, much more affordable price. So this table turned out stunning, but I had a serious crush on the cake table, from the crown resting on top of the cake table all the way down to the layers of blings and the intricate detail. It was just absolutely stunning. The cake looked amazing and it tasted amazing as well. Like, this was the first wedding I'd ever been to where like all the cake was gone and it was this big and like every single layer was gone. The cake table, the cake sat on this beautiful stand that was gifted to me by Very Carrie. Thank you so much, Carrie. And I love the knife set for the cake. I thought it was absolutely stunning and the detail there was simply amazing, as well as the detail on their toasting glasses. So overall, this room just turned out so beautiful. I absolutely love the way that all the flowers turned out and how well they meshed with the magenta tablecloths. And I love the different flowers used. And one of the things that we do in Lux Academy is properly curate the flowers and process the flowers. And the students really learned a lot about how to care for live flowers, because so many people get afraid of working with live flowers. But to me, they are just as easy, if not easier, than working with the silk ones. I love the detailing in the menu cards. Like, all of the stationery looked the exact same. So I love the napkin ring that the bride selected, again, from totallydazzled.com, and I will link that down below. But we made sure that the menu card, the invitations, all of the wedding signage, the songs for the table numbers, all of them had the exact same stationery, and it blended in with the flowers on each table. The bride was in love with bling, and so I could not help but to include these two amazing bling pieces on the back of her special guest table. And again, the bling from the centerpiece meshed so well with the bling on the napkins. So one of the things that I wanted to share with you guys at this point is that when you are putting together an event, even if you're doing a tablescape at your home, what you want to make sure is that every single thing on that table matches one another. Like, something ties back to the entire tablescape. They should all be related, you know? And so that's one of the things I think, you know, helps to make a beautiful event. Now, another thing that I think helps to make a beautiful event is keeping equipment like out of the view of the front view of the room. So I know a lot of people tend to put the band or the DJ in the front of a wedding. And me, I like to put them in the back. So when pictures are taken of the entire room, you don't have to worry about the equipment and cords and things like that being exposed in your wedding photos, because they are located in kind of an inconspicuous place. And that's kind of how I like to design. I put the DJ in a place where you can still hear him and you can still see him, but it won't be an eyesore. The cords and all of that won't be an eyesore in the actual photo. So whether I'm having a band or a DJ, I like to kind of keep them. I think about the picture, the wide angle picture of the room, and I kind of like to keep them, you know, outside of that entire scope. Now, of course, with us doing a video, we did get that area in the footage, but it's important for you guys to know why I place things the way that I place things in designing an entire space.
I don't want to wait. How long has it been since I felt like this about anything?
The head table is another important aspect of the room. Like, this is where you want all of your popping pieces to go. So whether that is a chair or a charger or a certain type of cutlery or whatever the case may be, you want to make sure that you bring that element of pop at the head table along with tons and tons of candlelight. You can see me and the Lux Academy team as well as my regular team in the back working there. And here is another overview of the sweetheart table. You can kind of see this better. The sun had started to set a little bit, so you could see the entire space a little bit better. So on the left hand side is the groom table, the groom cake table, and on the right hand side was the bride's cake table, and of course in the center was the sweetheart table. So that's just kind of how we do it here in the South. I do realize that in some other states you just have one wedding cake, but in the South it's our tradition to have both a groom cake and a bride cake. So I thought it was kind of strange when people were like, you have two cakes for a wedding? And I've just always known it to be a bride and a groom cake. So you guys let me know down in the comments below, at your wedding or weddings that you attend in your area, do they have one cake or do they have two cakes? Do they have a bride and a groom cake or just simply one wedding cake that they may place in the middle of the dance floor or some other area?
As long as I know that I'm winning, I play this game. But I want you close, baby, right now. I know you feel the same.
Now that you have seen all of the details, I'm going to show you what the room looks like from a panoramic view. So I'm going to do a quick sweep of the room and all of the tables. Everything turned out so amazing. The bride was so pleased at the way that the team performed. So a very special thank you to Lux Academy as well as the Lux Events team. I could not do this with you guys. You were absolutely amazing. And be sure to stay tuned for my Inside of Lux Academy look, where I just kind of briefly go through what we did and what we covered as a team. And if you're interested in joining my next Lux Academy class or my online class, visit me at www.melanieturner.design. So here is a glimpse from the reception. The bridal party and the bride and groom absolutely enjoyed themselves. Everything was absolutely beautiful. I was so pleased with how happy the bride and groom were. So thank you guys so much again for watching. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And again, I will leave all the links to the products that I featured in this video down in the description box below. And until next time, it's Melanie with Living Luxuriously for Less. Cheers!